is number 335.
God, come to my assistance.
Lord, make haste to help me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen. Alleluia.
May all the shining seraphim praise Him whom Christ so dearly loved, and may our lowly hymns resound in echo to angelic songs. The fount of wisdom was His school, to teach the glory of the Word, who with the Father ever dwells, yet filled His virgin mother's womb. The Master's love selected you. O happy John, great things to see, the glory shown on Tabor's height, the garden bitter agony. God of in ecstasy sublime, you were all out to contemplate the triumph of the spotless Lamb and of the Church's chosen bride. When dying Jesus gave to you His virgin mother as your make us her loving children too, and hide us in the heart of Christ. All glory to the Word divine, who took our flesh as truly man, who with the Father forever with their spirits love. Amen.
The God of our fathers glorified His servant Jesus. Alleluia. I trusted even when I said, I am sorely afflicted.
And when I said in my alarm, no man can be trusted.
How can I repay the Lord for His goodness to me?
The cup of salvation I will raise, I will call on the Lord's name.
My vows to the Lord I will fulfill before all His people.
O precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of His faithful.
Your servant, Lord, your servant am I. You have loosened my bonds.
A thanksgiving sacrifice I make. I will call on the Lord's name.
My vows to the Lord I will fulfill before all his people.
In the courts of the house of the Lord, in your midst, O Jerusalem. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen.
God of our fathers,
glorified his servant Jesus. Alleluia.
You have given birth to the Creator of the world, you who are ever virgin. Alleluia. How great is your name? We must work the works of him.
Work the works of him who sent me.
Alleluia. I will thank the Lord with all my heart in the meeting of the just and their assembly.
Great are the works of the Lord, to be pondered by all who love them.
Majestic and glorious his work. His justice stands firm forever.
He makes us remember his wonders. The Lord is in passion and love.
He gives food to those who fear him, keeps his covenant ever in mind.
He has shown his might to his people by giving them the lands of the nations.
His words are justice and truth. His precepts are all of them sure.
Standing firm forever and ever, they are made in uprightness and truth.
He has sent deliverance to his people and established his covenant forever. Holy is name to be feared.
To fear the Lord is the first stage of wisdom. All who do so prove themselves wise. His grace shall last forever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen. We must work the works of him who sent me.
We know and believe that God is love. I will give you glory, O God, my King. I will bless your name forever.
I will bless you day after day and praise your name forever.
The Lord is great, highly to be praised. His greatness cannot be measured.
Age to age shall proclaim your word. Shall declare your mighty deeds.
Shall speak of your splendor and glory. Tell the tale of your wonderful works.
They will speak of your terrible deeds. Recount your greatness and might.
They will recall your abundant goodness. Age to age shall ring out your justice.
The Lord is kind and full of compassion, slow to anger, abounding in love.
How good is the Lord to all, compassionate to all his creatures.
All your creatures shall thank you, O Lord, and your friends shall repeat their blessings.
They shall speak of the glory of your reign and declare your might, O God.
To make known to men your mighty deeds and the glorious splendor of your reign.
Yours is an everlasting kingdom. Your rule lasts from age to age.
The Lord is faithful in all his words and loving in all his deeds.
The Lord supports all who fall and raises all who are bowed down.
The eyes of all creatures look to you, and you give them their food in due time.
You open wide your hand, grant the desires of all who live.
The Lord is just in all his ways and loving in all his deeds.
He is close to all who call him, who call on him from their hearts.
He grasps the desires of those who fear him. He hears their cry and he saves them.
The Lord protects all who love him, but the wicked he will utterly destroy.
Let me speak the praise of the Lord. Let all mankind bless his holy name forever, for ages unending. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen.
We know and believe that God is love. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God. Alleluia. Praised be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ,
who has bestowed on us in Christ every spiritual blessing in the heavens.
God chose us in him before the world began to be holy and blameless in his sight.
He predestined us to be his adopted sons through Jesus Christ.
Such was his will and pleasure, that all might praise the glorious favor he has bestowed on us in his beloved.
In him and through his blood we have been redeemed, and our sins forgiven. So immeasurably generous is God's favor to us.
God has given us the wisdom to understand fully the mystery, the plan he was pleased to decree in Christ,
a plan to be carried out in Christ in the fullness of time, to bring all things into one in him, in the heavens and on earth. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen.
See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God. Alleluia.
They devoted themselves to the apostles' instruction and the communal life, to the breaking of bread and prayers. A reverent fear overtook them all, for many wonders and signs were performed by the apostles. Those who believed shared all things in common. They would sell their property and goods, dividing everything on the basis of each one's need.
Mode 5. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior.
For he has looked with favor on his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed.
The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name.
He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation.
He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit.
He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly.
He has filled the hungry with good things. And the rich he has sent away empty.
He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy,
the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever.
Glory to the Father and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever.
My brothers and sisters, we build on the foundation of the apostles. Let us pray to our Almighty Father for his holy people and say,
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison,
Father. Father, you wanted your Son to be seen first by the apostles after the resurrection from the dead. We ask you to make us his witnesses to the farthest corners of the world.
Kyrie eleison.
You sent your Son to preach the good news to the poor. Help us to preach this gospel to every creature.
Kyrie eleison.
You send your Son to sow the seed of unending life. Grant that we who work at sowing the seed may share the joy of the harvest.
Kyrie eleison.
You send your Son to reconcile all men to you through his blood. Help us all to work toward achieving this reconciliation.
Kyrie eleison.
For vocations to our community, to religious life, to the priesthood, for all our oblates, and then for our future oblates here in Denver, for our benefactors, for our families, for our superiors.
For Father Mary Jacques.
For the project of acquiring the new house for the priory and for the Regina Chile Heritage Project.
For Sharon Mason, all of her intentions for her family.
For our students and for next year's class.
For all those who asked us for our prayers on the occasion of this Christmas time.
Your Son sits at your right hand in heaven. Let the dead enter your kingdom of joy.
Kyrie eleison.
Pater noster,
qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem, sed libera nos a malo.
Let us pray. O God, who through the blessed Apostle John have unlocked for us the secrets of your word, grant, we pray, that we may grasp with proper understanding what he has so marvelously brought to our ears, to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
May the divine assistance be always with us.
And also with our brothers and sisters.
Martyrology, December the 27th. Solemnity of St. John, apostle and evangelist, titular and principal patron of our community. The son of Zebedee, a fisherman on the lake of Tiberias and a brother of St. James, he was initially a disciple of St. John the Baptist. Then the precursor stepped aside so that John might follow the Lamb. During the years of Christ's apostolic life, he experienced a privileged intimacy with Jesus as the beloved disciple. At the Last Supper, he rested on his master's chest, and, having been the only disciple to witness the cross, he received Mary as his mother. He wrote the book of Revelation, three canonical letters, and the fourth gospel. According to tradition, he died at Ephesus. At Alexandria, the year of grace, 288, St. Maximus Bishop. He supported the famous theology school of the city, and in view of preserving Catholic faith, communicated the decisions of the Council of Antioch to the churches of Egypt. In the 9th century, Saints Theophane, Bishop, and Theodore, monk, victims of the iconoclastic dispute. Elsewhere, the heavenly birth of numerous other saints whose names are inscribed in the Book of Life.